Hello and welcome to part one of a series of tutorials where I will show you how to model a dinosaur. Now this is the dinosaur that we're gonna be making in this series. So this is a real good this is a good exercise for creating quadrupeds and learning how to create quadrupeds. Now this is the dinosaur that we're going to be modeling in this tutorial. When we're going to start and we're going to continue in the next series of tutorials. This is not going to be too difficult to model, so it shouldn't be too difficult to model it. The first thing to do is go online and find a series of images to serve as our references to use in the process of modeling. Now this is really helpful because it helps in the modeling process when it comes to getting all the anatomy and the details. Getting all those details, also having close-ups, different shots, different angles of the concept that we're going to be working with. So I have a few pictures here, and all these pictures you can download from my website. Now these don't belong to me, but not really selling them to you. I'm not taking credit for these pictures, but you can use them anytime. You can download them from my website. Now this is the picture that I'm going to be using as my main reference. This is the one I'm going to be using in the side view. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's open Maya, of course. Now spacebar to get all the four views here. So now what we're going to do is we're going to get the reference image. The easiest way of doing that is if you click in this icon. Another way is you go to image plane here and import image. I'm going to use this image. This is going to be the one that I'm going to be working with. So let's go back to the perspective view. Now I'll prefer to work with meters. By default, we're working with centimeters. So if you go to window, settings, preferences, preferences, now if you click here, and here you have the And here you have the choice to change to from centimeters to meters. So now our picture is a little too small, so we're going to select the image in the viewport and we're coming here to the side and just type a number just to make it larger. I'm also going to maybe slightly bigger, larger image here. Now also slide it on the X. Now I'm pressing the middle mouse button, I'm holding it and holding the middle mouse button and drag. Okay, spacebar to go back to our four views here. So let's start by creating a polygon primitive cube. Now pressing 5 for shaded mode. Now come here to the side and let's add an extra division here. Set it to 2. Now let's scale it to more appropriately fit with the image that we got here. Now select faces and select this side. Now we're just going to delete that. Now select the whole object, go to Edit, and click on the Options box for the Duplicate Special. Now you're going to get this menu. Just make sure that you have it set to Instance and that all these numbers are this way. I have a minus negative 1 here for the X. Okay. So now whatever we do to one side is going to be mirrored to the other side. But we also want to double click on the move tool here. I'm going to switch to drag select. And I'm also going to enable reflection on the X, make sure that reserve scene is checked so that whenever we try to move anything that's here, it's not going to move. Now just press 3 to work on subdivision mode. And this is the time when we start shaping. Now this is what we're doing right now, is just some simple blocking of the shape that we want. So I'm working in the side view here and also perspective at the same time. I have those two open so that I can see better what I'm doing. What I'm going to do is insert an edge loop, go to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool. We'll use the side view and click over here. Now it's difficult to see on the side view, but you can see it in the perspective. Now maybe another one here. Okay. I'm going to side view. I know it's difficult to see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to disable the grid. By disabling the grid so that you can see the image better. So if you go to show and disable grid, it helps for you to see this better. Now we start making some shape adjustments here to better match the image. Now I'm mainly working with the side view for now. All I'm doing is grabbing some edges and adjusting them. This might be really difficult to see, so I really, really recommend that you watch the video in high definition. Move it back so I can see how that looks in our perspective view. So let's go back and check our pictures. Since we're in Maya, we're only working with our side view. That's why I have other pictures here that can help us when it comes to the time of shaping the frontal view. Now, I couldn't find any frontal view images, so that's going to make it a little more difficult for us to shape, but I got this one. This image is closest to resemble the frontal view. So let's continue with our shaping process here. And select that edge loop and move it down. And select this edge loop and move that up. Let's insert an edge loop. If you go to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool, and insert that there. And now we continue with the shaping process. Making sure that you're looking at the reference image that we got there so that we can closely get to that shape. I'm constantly looking at the back picture so that I'm sure that I'm getting the shape the way I want it. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to insert a natural loop. I'm pressing G to load the last selection. I'm going to continue to shape it so that I can get the neck area here. Continue to shape. So this is going to be the neck area. Hopefully you can see this. Let's go back to perspective view. It's good to keep going from our perspective view to our side view so that we know that the model is resembling the image. So basically here we have our really basic blocking of the body. Now make sure you always save your scenes. It's a good thing to save very often, just in case Maya crashes or anything of that nature. Now we're gonna stop here for now. In the next video, we're going to continue to shape, maybe get the legs and the tail and some more of the neck, so that we can get going with our modeling process. Okay. Okay, so we continue with part 2 here of the modeling process. So last time where we left off was really, really the basic blocking of the dinosaur here, mainly the body. So what we're going to start to think about is probably getting to modeling the legs. It might be tempting to extrude this face, but I think this one works better in our case here. So what we do is we're going to edit mesh, extrude. And I'm going to hit W for the regular manipulator, pressing E to rotate this. Hopefully it's not too difficult to see. Now pressing G to extrude. G one more time to extrude, now pressing W just to grab that down. Making sure that on the side view it matches. Of course we're going to continue to shape after we do this. So I hit G one more time to extrude. And G one last time. Now what G does is it loads the last tool that you used. In this case we were using the extrude, so that's why G extrudes in this case. So we have the basic leg here, so that's probably we're going to get to shaping it. If we go into edge mode, maybe here in the side view, we can start doing some adjustments here so that it matches with the image that we're using. Now of course we have some limited geometry here, so that all we're doing is getting the really basic blocking of the leg. So what we're doing is just some simple shaping. Let's go into a perspective view so that we grab this edge, move it out and up, grab this edge, move it in, this one as well. Some really basic shaping for now. But it's good to start shaping in the earlier stages, just so that you get the basic blocking of the shape that we want. Okay. So just grabbing some edges and maybe moving them one at a time, it helps, especially at this stage where we have limited geometry, just grabbing one at a time to create that shape. It's useful, it's really useful. Let me insert an edge loop. Go to edit mesh, insert edge loop, just so that we have more geometry to continue to shape. Now go here in side view so that we can match that to the image. Back to the perspective. It's probably time to get the other leg going. So we can select this face. Let me do some slight shaping before we get the leg. Really slightly, some changes here. I'm actually going to grab these faces, and maybe this is going to be the tail, where the tail starts. I'm going to press G to insert the edge loop. Maybe here. Now do some shaping. It's always good to work with all the views that you have available to you in Maya. In this case, I'm working mainly with the perspective. At the same time, I'm working with the side view, so that I know how everything's shaping. So let's go back into a perspective view here. So let's get into extruding the back legs. So what we do is, once again, we go to edit mesh, extrude. I'm going to press the W. And then going to rotate that. Pressing E to rotate. Before I continue, I'm going to do some minor shaping up here. Just some really minor adjustments before I continue with the leg. If you have problems seeing the manipulator in the side view, if you select this thing, you move it to the side. So now when you're working with the side view, you can see the manipulator. Sometimes that helps in order to see it in the side view. Okay, so let's continue and extrude the rest of the leg. So press G, pressing W, G one more time. Bring that down. One last time, G. Now let's do some minor adjustments to fit the image. Okay, let's go into our side view here so that we have more screen space. Okay, some adjustments probably here, so we can actually see the other leg in the background. G
keep looking at that image that you have there in the side, just to make sure. Grab this edge. Making sure that the model is well built. Just continue to shape. Sometimes working at the vertex level can also be helpful. So at this point we still have a basic blocking of the dinosaur here. So we're gonna stop here for now. We're going to continue next time, probably the neck and the tail and some more shaping. Okay, we'll continue next tutorial. Okay, so we continue with part 3 now of our dinosaur mesh here. So we continue to model the we can continue to shape the neck now. So I'm going to insert edge loop and insert one here so that we can start to shape the neck. Let's select these two faces in and drag that up so that we can get that shape of the neck. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert an edge loop by pressing G. So insert another edge loop there. Again, I pressed G. And continue to shape. Another way of doing this is instead of moving that face, those faces up and inserting that edge loop, you could have selected those faces and extrude, and you could have extruded them and press G here and insert another edge loop. I think that doing it this way is it's not a problem at all. You get the same results in the end anyways. You go to the side view here, I mean perspective view here. So I want this edge loop to be straight, but if I press R to scale and then come to the scale option box here. So if I select normals, normally that gives me a good result, but in this case it's not giving me what I want. So to make this edge loop straight, what I'm going to do is select a custom axis, and I'm going to select edge. And so I click on this edge. Now I select this handle here to scale that and see how that makes that edge loop straight. We can do that with this one as well. Okay. Now make sure to go back to world. Now we continue to shape. And we scale that. going to rotate this. Maybe scale that. And move it this way, perhaps. I'm going to press G to insert an edge loop. Actually, let's go to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop. Scale that in and grab it. Let's rotate this. I know it might be slightly boring to just watch me shape, let me insert an edge loop here, just watching me shape the model here, but sometimes it helps just to see how someone else does it. And of course there isn't one absolute way of doing this. So now we got the neck going. And we can start some more shaping in this area here before we get too crazy up there with the head. Let's get more shaping here with the body. Going to insert an edge loop, pressing G, or just by going to insert edge loop tool. Now I'm going to the side view, making sure that I'm getting the shape the way I want it. Grabbing those faces. Basically the same process that we did with the neck. G to insert an edge loop. Scale that in. Okay. What I'm doing is moving these faces so that I get that shape of the tail the way I want it. In this case, I wanted to look more in like the image that we got here. Insert an edge loop, G. Or again, you can just go to the Edit Mesh, insert edge loop 2. Okay, now we got the basic blocking for the tail there. And we can start to do more. Develop the shape, continue to develop it by shaping here, moving some edges. We're slowly but surely getting the shape that we're looking for here. This is all about patience. We need patience to get to that point. Let me check the pictures here so that it's a good idea to have these pictures available to you so that you keep looking at them and just to make sure that the models matches the images. Of course, these are not all the same images, but they give you an idea of where we're going with this. So I keep going back to those images. Keep going back and forth between the images and the model, even though I already have one image that I'm using here in Maya. Still helps having all those images. Let's go to Mesh, Sculpt Geometry Tool. Now the radius is really tiny, so let's click here. With Sculpt Geometry Tool options. Now I'm going to make sure that here I'm going to choose the relax tool and to change the radius. Now just adjust the slider here. What it does is it relaxes the geometry here. This is actually super helpful when it comes to, say, you have something that's really lumpy. It makes it slightly rounder and it relaxes the geometry here. Just to relax those hard edges that sometimes you get. Again, I'm using the sculpt geometry tool and I'm using the relax. You can press Q to exit. And actually, you can press Q for any other tool. Whenever you want to drop a tool, just press Q. That way, you're not using that tool anymore. So as we can see, we have a basic shape of the dinosaur here, and it's starting to come along. Now, if we look at our pictures, making sure that we have the anatomy, and that it gives us an idea of what to look for, how things should look like. Let me set up this face here. Scale that. So I think we're going to do some slight shaping here and. Just to get the shape of the model. So I'm probably going to stop now. We're going to stop here for now, and in the next video we're going to continue to probably develop the head. So before we go, one thing we're going to do is we're going to delete our history is over here. And to do that, we go to Edit, Delete by Type History, just so that it doesn't slow Maya, okay? So next time we're going to continue in the modeling process. In the meantime, I recommend that you continue to shape it to your liking. Okay, so we continue with the model of our dinosaur here. So last time where we left off was we had the basic silhouette of the dinosaur by following the image that we were using. So now we probably want to develop the head. Probably want to do some slight shaping here before we go ahead and get started in creating the head area. So I'm going to do is select the whole object first, and we're going to subdivide this. We're going to mesh, smooth options box. Just make sure that you have the options set the same way I have here. Especially make sure that the options where it says here preserve seam are not checked. And apply that. So now we have more geometry that we can use to shape our model. So let's select these faces. So we're going to edit mesh, extrude, pressing W, and before we do anything, I'm going to double click here and disable reflection for now. Just move that forward. Okay. maybe slightly down. Let's go to our side view here so that we match the image. So now I'm going to select the interface and enable reflection once again and delete. Okay, I'm going to select these faces and I'm actually going to grow the selection just so that we can match the reference image better. Going to rotate this. Just to get it to match as close as possible. I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect, but as long as you're happy with the results, it should be good. Now let's insert an edge loop. Let's go to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop. Let's do some slight shaping. Now we're going to select these faces. Make sure you have those faces selected so that we can get the mouth. So we're going to Edit Mesh and you guessed it, Extrude. Let's scale that in. G to extrude one more time. And I'm going to use the blue handle to bring that in. Now we're going to delete, and we're going to select these faces and delete those as well. Now if you notice, we have a gap here in some of our edges here, so we're going to select those edges. Now this might be a little difficult to see, but select those edges. And we're going to snap those back into place. So we go here, up here, and we type 0 in the X. And you see that it snaps that into place. We're going to do the same with this, the bottom part. Type 0 in the X, and that snaps back to the 0 of the X. So we have the basic mouth. So let's do some slight shaping as we go along. Now I'm trying to do this as slow as possible. I'm trying to do this really slowly. So if you're an advanced user, this might be slightly boring. So let's check our pictures. It's a good idea to keep going back to our pictures, especially the face. Keep going back to the picture, especially that the head image. I have different close-ups here. Again, you can download those images from my website, or you can just Google. Continue to shape. Now this is a slow process, but we have to be patient, and shortly but surely we're gonna get to where we want to. So you can see that I keep going back to those images. Let me insert an edge loop, edit mesh, insert edge loop. And continue to develop the shape that we want. I just want to make sure to show every single step that I do. So we probably want to get the inside of the mouth. So the way of doing that, we're going to select these edges here. Make sure you have those edges selected. So we're going to edit mesh and extrude. I'm going to press W to move. And I'm going back to that zero here, so that it snaps to the axis. Of course, we want to close the hole that we got here. First, we're going to insert edge loops here. So we're going to edit mesh, insert edge loop, probably one here, maybe one there. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to use the merge vertex tool. So if you go to edit mesh, merge vertex tool, so click and hold down one of the vertices and drag it to the one that you want to snap it to. It's really difficult to see in the subdivision mode, so you might want to press 1 to go to a lower division. So I'm pressing 1 so I can go back to my regular. Again, I'm using the merge vertex tool. So click and hold that vertex and drag it. Now here I see that we probably need another edge loop. So what I'm going to do is go to the edit mesh and insert edge loop and insert one there. Now let's go back to the merge vertex tool. Select that vertex. Oops. Make sure you select the one that you want to merge. Okay. So if we press 3, that's looking fine there. That's the way we want it. So let's go ahead and do the same with the... Let's repeat the process with the top. Again, press 1. Sometimes you see that some edges are selected. And let me select them and deselect them. Okay, so we're going to use the merge vertex tool once again. So if you go to edit mesh, merge vertex tool, click and hold, and drag. Okay, let me go back to my 3 subdivision mode. So that's looking fine there. So now probably we want to continue to shape. So I really want to show my shaping process here. We really want to get to the shape that we want. Let's keep looking back. Going back to our pictures. just so that we can follow more precisely. Keep going back to those pictures. I'm going to press B for soft selection. So hold down B and hold down the left mouse and drag to change the radius. Now soft selection allows for selecting one edge and it moves the other edges that are close to that one so that we can move more than one edge at a time. It can be really useful. So really all I'm doing is some more shaping here. Notice it's a slow process, but we're going to get there eventually. Trying to do this as slow as possible so that you can see. Of course, once again, there's not one way of doing things. So let's do more shaping. Continue to shape. This is a slow process, but again, we need to have some patience when it comes to making models. So we continue to shape. Of course, this is all up to you if you want to be really faithful to the image and follow it to the T, or maybe go slightly more stylized. Now in this case I'm following the image, but at the same time I'm not feeling that I'm bound to it, so it's all up to you. So really this is some just moving things around to get to that shape that we want. And that's basically what this is. Especially at this stage, what we're gonna do is continue to shape. So we continue to shape the rest of the body as well. Now we have more geometry to work with, so we can continue to shape accordingly to the image. So what we're doing is moving edges. Now you probably noticed that I'm mainly using edges to move around, but of course you can use vertices and faces. So I think we're going to stop here for now, and on the next tutorial we're going to continue to develop the shape and probably get the eyes done and continue to shape especially the head and the body of the dinosaur. Okay, so let's continue where we left off last time. So last time we got to make the basics of the head and extruded the mouth. So at this point what we want to do is continue to shape and select these faces. And select these faces as well. And grow the selection. And do some shaping, move those in. So now we're getting into modeling the head. So let's look at these pictures. These pictures are going to help us in the process, especially getting the head right. Now, not all these pictures are exactly the same, so in this picture it looks like the nostrils are over here. Although maybe it could be there as well. This picture obviously has the nostrils here, but this picture doesn't have those nostrils here, but here. Although this picture seems to be slightly different than the others. I don't know if it might be a difference in the species of dinosaur, but I think they're similar enough. So now I'm going to choose which one we're going to follow. I think I'm going to follow this picture. I prefer it. Although I think the nostrils should be here. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to try to recreate this one, and I'm going to add that part. Probably going to make the nostrils here, like in the other pictures. So I'm going to follow this picture. So now we want to think about, let's do some shaping before we think about creating the eyes. Well, I'm doing some more shaping. So now I have to decide where to extrude the eyes. Now, normally when I create a character like this, I normally select these eyes, I mean these faces, to extrude for the eyes. But in this case, I think that, especially in this picture, the eye is really on the side here. So in this case I'm probably going to have to compromise from how I normally do it. So I'm probably going to have to select these faces to extrude instead of the ones I normally use. Although I might be able to use these, let me check. No, I don't think it's going to work. So I'm just going to select these two faces and use those for my eye. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's use those. So let's go to Edit Mesh, Extrude. Let's scale that in. And I'm just going to select edges and start to shape to make this slightly rounder and create that shape of the eye. Make the eye slightly more round so that it matches more with the image that we have. Maybe bring those in. So I'll do G to extrude one more time. G one more time to extrude. And one last time. And bring that in. And we're going to delete those faces. And now let's get this area more round. So let's do some shaping. Let's continue to shape. And continue to look at the images so that we can match that as close as possible. Look at the image. Grab some edges with a combination of using soft selection. We create the jawline here. I think it's time to get that area. So maybe select these faces. Let's take a look. we're going to edit mesh, extrude, press W and disable reflection. And we get that area. Now select the interfaces. We go ahead and enable reflection and delete. Now what I did there, I did control spacebar. If you ever need more screen space, when you tap control and spacebar, you get more screen space without all the menus to the side. That way you have more space to work with. Let's keep looking at the image so that we can continue to shape. Let me insert an edge loop. So we continue to look at the images. I mean, slowly but surely we're getting there. Our shape it's starting to look more or less like the image. So I keep going back to that image just to make sure I'm on the right track. I think we want to extrude that. It's probably about time to get that area. As you can see in this picture, it also has that area here, that crease inside. I'm not sure those are supposed to be the nostrils. I don't think so. I mean, this picture doesn't even have it. But we're going to do that. We're going to add it here. So I'm going to select that face. So let's go to Edit Mesh, Extrude. Bring that in just so that I get that shape. Let's G to extrude one more time. And now let's do some more shaping. Let me insert an edge loop. You can go to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop Tool. Now I used a keyboard shortcut. I have a whole tutorial about that if you're interested. If you're going to get close to something, say I select these edges, if you press F to fit selection to get close to that area. So if you select a few edges, faces, or birds, and press F, it fits to that selection. So let's continue to shape. And of course, we could go into our image. Now for these videos, I really just wanted to show everything that I do in the process 100%, and not, this is basically uncut. Everything I've done is it's gonna be shown in these videos, nothing's gonna be cut. So every step is gonna be shown. So now we wanna go ahead and extrude those nostrils that I mentioned earlier. So in this picture we don't see those, but we're gonna add them. Let me insert an edge loop here again by going to insert edge loop from the edit mesh menu. Now this series of tutorials is it's really for almost any level. I mean, if you're a beginner, there's no problem with following. You shouldn't have a problem following this. All you would need to know is where the menus are and how to navigate Maya. Other than that, you could basically follow really easily. So we're gonna stop here for now, I believe, and next time we're probably going to continue to shape the head. We might get the teeth done perhaps, and we're going to shape the overall body in the next video. Okay, so let's continue where we left off last time. So last time we were doing some shaping, we got some of the head area done, and so in this video we have to continue to shape. First we do go to edit, delete by type history, so that we can delete our history for now. It's always a good thing to do that. So we continue to shape with fit selection here. So let's continue shaping. Let me grow the selection. I'm going to press B for soft selection. Let me increase the radius and grab this. Maybe reposition and scale that down slightly. So it's always a good thing to just continue to shape and develop the form that you're looking for. And it can be a slow process, but eventually you'll get to a point where you think that you got the overall shape matching to the image. Just continue to do more shaping. Again, I wanted to show everything that I do in the shaping process so that you have an idea. Let's look at the images here. And then probably we need to start thinking about adding the nostrils here, or at least what I think could be the nostrils, especially. Now this one doesn't have that, but We're going to add it anyway. So I'm going to select this face. I'm probably going to edit mesh and extrude. Now before, let me turn reflection off. So if you look what reflection did, it selected the whole object when I extrude it. So that's why I'm going to turn that disable reflection at this point. Now let's enable reflection. Let me select this loop so that I type 0 here. So get that back into place. Maybe G to extrude one more time. Looks a little too strong, so let's move some of the edges around to soften that area. This is technically the nostrils, or at least what I think are the nostrils in the pictures. Okay, so I'm going to select this edge and I'm going to edit mesh, spin edge forward, and press G. Now what I did there was it allowed to change the edge flow. I just wanted to soften that area of the nostrils, so I all I did was spin that edge. So now let's continue to shape. So that spin edge loop tool is really helpful if you want to change the edge flow. Let's go to mesh and use the sculpt geometry tool. Let me change the radius. I'm just going to relax some of this area here using the sculpt geometry tool set to relax. It helps sometimes when you have really hard edges. Just press Q to exit. Now press Ctrl Spacebar, so that you get more screen space. Whenever you tap Control Spacebar, you get more screen space. So let's continue to shape. So at this point, it's a good idea just to continue to shape until you're happy with the results that you're getting. Again, all I'm doing is shaping. I know it could be boring, but it can be boring just to watch me doing this, but sometimes it's helpful. So moving some edges with the combination of soft selection to create that form. I'm gonna get the neck slightly rounder here. So I'm just gonna move some of the edges. Again, I'm just moving edges. I'm using soft selection. And of course, you're not bound to just moving the edges. You can remember, you can move faces and vertices, not just edges. Now let me just redefine the form here for the leg. I mean, right now it's all about shaping, getting that form. Don't worry, we're gonna get to all the other details in a minute here, so that we can get back to the head and the feet. We continue to look at that picture of the background that we have here so that it can closely resemble our form here to the image. Of course, we don't have a frontal view, but we're gonna have to work with that, with what we have. We might want to start thinking about creating the feet. I think this picture is really helpful, so we can see the toes. I think I can see that, especially in this picture, I believe he only has three toes. But for now, we're going to continue to shape. We're going to get that in a minute here. Soft selection is really helpful when it comes to shaping these things. So we just continue to shape, and just looking at that picture that I have here in the back, that side view image. And I couldn't find a picture of a back view, so I'm going to have to kind of guess how that looks. I'm not too happy with this area here. I might come back to that later. Just try to get as close as possible to maybe a combination of all the images that we have. I mean, they all have they're very similar anyways, so, and it's the same dinosaur, I suppose. So I think for now we're going to stop here, and we're going to continue next time. I think next time we're going to get to the teeth, and maybe get the toes done, and slightly more shaping. Of course, we always have to continue to shape. So we're going to stop here for now. So we'll continue next time. Okay. Okay. So let's continue with part 7 now. So we continue where we left off last time, and so now we're going to try and get the toes done, and I think we're going to try to get the teeth done as well. So let's get started, and let's get the toes ready. So I'm going to press 1. I'm going to select these faces here. I'm going to scale on the Y, just to make that flat. Let me scale that here, that there. I'm going to grab some of the edges up. Let me grab this up, go back to 1. So now let's look at the picture, so that just to make sure that we're on the right track. So I'm going to look at the pictures that has the toes. Now this one you can barely see them, so this one's not too helpful in that. So let's look at this one. Now this one shows that he has 3 toes, so it's really easy to see from this picture. So we're going to use this image, we're going to be looking at this image of the toes, so that we can get kind of close to resembling this image. So let's go ahead and I'm going to select some of the faces here. I think I'm going to select these 3 faces for the toes. Actually, let me select this, move this up. Now select those 3 faces, and we're going to edit mesh, and first we're going to make sure that this is not selected, and now we extrude. We scale that, and now we're going to use the blue handle, move those down. I'm going to press 3 just to see how that looks in the subdivision mode. I think that looks fine for now. Maybe we can come back in a few minutes and do some slight shaping. So now let's do the same with the back. here, select those three faces, go to Edit Mesh, Extrude, and then going to use the blue handle here. Move those down, and we press 3 just to see how that looks. The reason I'm pressing 3 to see how that looks is because I'm going to subdivide the mesh later. So let's select the three faces one more time, go to Edit Mesh, and this time make sure to check that, and extrude. I'm going to use the blue handle, G to extrude one more time. Scale those. Let me grow the selection here. So now let's do the same with the front. G to extrude. G one more time to extrude and scale these ones. I'm going to press W and grab those down. I'm just going to grow the selection. Move those up. We can always come back to that later. So let's continue to do some shaping here so that we can get that silhouette that we're looking for. So let's get back to the head, see what we got here. So something I forgot to do last time was, let me show you some of the pictures here, some of the close-ups of the mouth. So something I forgot was to kind of add this area so that we get that crease in. So I think I'm going to add it. Now this picture is not too visible, so you might be able to get away without adding that and just doing some slight shaping. So I'm gonna let you decide whether you want to add it or not. But in this case, I'm actually going to add it. So I'm going to add this area here with a simple extrusion. So you can follow or not. So select those two faces if you're going to follow me. So do edit mesh and extrude. Now this is something that I could have done maybe earlier in the stages, but I totally forgot, so I'm doing it now. And I'm probably going to have to spin some of the edges so that I can have a better flow or geometry here. So I'm actually going to edit mesh. I'm going to use this spin edge forward tool. Now don't follow for now, and I just want to see what I get. I'm just playing with the edge flow here to get something that I like. So you don't have to follow for now, and let me just selecting some of the edges and spinning them. See if I get something that I like in terms of the edge flow. So I'm just spinning some of the edges, and I'm pressing G. I just want to get a better edge flow. I like this one. I think I like it this way. I think that might work. So yeah, I'm going to select that edge, and again I want to spin edge forward and G, and I'm going to leave it this way, that edge. I think I like the edge flow for that area. So I'm going to continue just to play with the top now, see if I get some geometry, the edge flow better looking here. Again, I'm just playing with the edge flow. I just want to see if I get better flowing geometry here. I'm just trying to get something that I like, that I'm comfortable with, in terms of the edge flow. I think it kind of looks okay for now, though. I'm not too happy about this star here, so I want to minimize that. Well, I think I kind of like it. I think this one might work. I know it might be difficult to follow what I just did, so I was basically just spinning some of the edges to kind of create a better flow with geometry here. So I think I'm going to leave it this way. Yeah, I think it works this way. Just trying different combinations here, just to see what I get. So I think I'm just going to leave it this way for now. So maybe if it's
if it's possible, just to get as close as possible to what I got here. So let me select some of the inside faces here. I'm going to move those inwards so that we have more of the mouth area in there. So let's do more shaping before we get into creating the teeth. Let me insert an edge loop. By doing that, you can do that by going to Edit Mesh, Insert Edge Loop. Again, I'm using a keyboard shortcut for my Insert Edge Loop. And if you're interested in learning how to do that, I have a whole tutorial dedicated to that in case you're interested. So let's continue to shape. So we are getting to that point where we're getting there, and starting to get that shape that we were looking for. So at this point we're doing some more shaping, and we're not worrying about adding geometry for now, just let's continue to shape. So I think I'm going to stop here for now, and I'm going to let you continue to shape. So in the next video we're going to
create the teeth for sure. That's what we're going to do for sure in the next video. And we're going to subdivide, and perhaps by the next video we're going to actually be done with the whole modeling process. Okay, so we continue with the modeling process of the dinosaur here that was started up, I believe, 7 videos ago. So this is part 8. So let's continue where we left off. In this video, I'm going to show you for sure, as promised, how to create the teeth. So here's the model that we've been working with, and so let's get to the head area here. So first what we're going to do is delete our history, go to delete by type history. It's a good thing to delete your history as often as possible. So now we could make an extrusion for the gum line here, but I think we can get away with once you're in the texturing process, maybe by just using color, we can create that look of the gum line instead of actually making an extrusion. Although you could just make an extrusion for the gum line, but in this case, I'm just going to leave it this way. So let's look at some of the pictures here. So we probably want to get the tongue area before we get to our teeth. Okay, so I'm going to. Let me insert an edge loop. If you go to edit mesh, insert edge loop. So let's do some really minor adjustments here before we get ahead of ourselves. So let's select, now it might be difficult to see, so go to edit mesh, extrude. Before we do anything else, go to disable reflection. Going to move those up, and this might be difficult to see, but select the inner faces, make sure you select those faces and enable reflection and delete. So now it's probably a good time to start to shape it. Now this is really difficult to get in there and shape it, but it has to be done. So probably this wouldn't be a very good animatable tongue here. So if you wanted to animate it really well, you probably would. It would be preferable to maybe create a different object for it instead of extruding off the mouth. It would be a better idea to make it as a separate object if you were to animate this. But in this case, I just need an extrusion because I know for sure I'm not going to animate this, and I'm just modeling. Now, because it's so difficult to see the inside, let me get back to Marquee Select and select some of the faces here. I'm going to Isolate Select, if you click here. That way we only see this area. We only see the faces that we selected. Let me go back to drag select, and I can see that I have some overlapping faces, so I can move those down. And of course, we continue to shape, making sure that we don't have any overlapping geometry here. Of course, it's really, really difficult to see, especially since I extruded off of the mouth. Let's continue to shape. And no worries, we're going to get to the teeth here in a minute. So let's go ahead and we're going to create the teeth now. Let me save the scene, then go to create polygon primitives. I'm going to use a cube, believe it or not. It's going to work fine with this process here. Now scale that down. Let me look at the pictures to make sure I get the shape that I want. I'm going to press 3 and scale that. Maybe select that top face and scale that in. I don't think that works. That looks fine to me. Let's go to mesh, smooth, press 1. Now I'm going to press G to smooth one more time. I think that works. It looks fine to me. And let me scale that slightly. Now, before I make a duplicate of this object, what I want to do is want to create the UVs for it, so that all the duplicates that I make from this object are going to share the same UV space. That way I don't have to be going back and creating the UVs for all of them. And next we're going to make duplicates of this one, and it's going to share the same UV space. Let me isolate select first. Now go to create, make sure it's set to bounding box. I'm going to select let me go back here and select some of the edges. I'm going to select that all the way here. Make sure you have those edges selected. So let's go to Window, UV Texture Editor. Now click here. Go to Polygons, Cut UV Edges. Now go back to Polygons, Unfold. And I think the options are fine. Now go back to Polygons, Layout. Okay, now click here. Click here, and we're going to get this. Now click and drag where it says unfold. Okay, so I think that looks good for our UVs there. We'll go back to our object, and now it's time to start to place the teeth in place, and we're going to make duplicates. So let's go delete history for it first. So now let's start to place and rotate. I think they're really small. So do Control D to make a duplicate. And place that. So I'm going to just continue and make duplicates by Control D and placing all these where I think that they're going to look fine according to the picture. So I'm going to continue to do this, and I'm going to stop the recording, and I'm going to come back once I'm done Okay, so what I did, so I made a bunch of duplicates and I placed them exactly where I wanted them. Okay, so first what I'm going to do is I'm going to combine all the teeth so that they're one object. So select the whole thing, shift, then click the dinosaur to deselect it, shift, and click here to deselect. So now make sure you only have all the teeth selected. Go to mesh, combine. So now you can see the one object. If you click here, you see the one object. And now if you go to window UV texture editor, you can see that they're all sharing the same UV that we created first. So they're going to be using the same texture. So let's go ahead and create the eye. We're going to create polygon primitives, a sphere. Let's move that into place. Let's scale that accordingly. Let me rotate it and actually rotate 90 degrees here. Move that into place. So I'm going to go to select this sphere and going to isolate select, and I'm going to, I know for sure that I'm not going to see this area, so I'm going to select those faces and grow the selection. And I'm going to delete. That's mainly because I know that for sure that's not going to be visible. So I think that at this point we're actually close to the final results that we're looking for. So let me go to mesh and smooth so that we have more divisions available here to us so that we can continue to shape. I mean, the more geometry you have, the more you can shape. So now we have more geometry to work with, so we can really come in and continue to shape the model as we like. So that allows for some more shaping, more geometry available to us. So at this point, I think that we're done actually with the modeling process. So the next thing that we have to do is we have to make sure that we mirror the geometry next time. And the next time we're going to UV unwrapped, if you want to learn how to do that for this dinosaur, and we're going to mirror to make sure that we have one object instead of two pieces. So next time I'm going to show you how to UV unwrapped, and it's actually going to be a wrap-up of the whole tutorial series in terms of the modeling process. Okay, so let's continue with the dinosaur model here. So we're actually done with the modeling process, and at this point what we want to do is we're going to create the UVs so that if you're going to take this to a 3D or 2D texturing program, you probably would need to create the UVs for it. So it would be it shouldn't be too difficult of a task to UV unwrap this dinosaur. So in this case, I want the dinosaur to actually be symmetrical. So in this case, what I'm going to do is UV unwrap only one side, so that we don't have to UV unwrap the whole thing. So I'm going to delete one side, and we're going to create, and we're going to select the planar mapping, and make sure it's set to bounding box. Now it's time to select all the edges that we want to cut. You can use the select edge loop tool, but you can just use the regular edge loop mode. So we need to select some of the edges that we're going to cut in order to UV unwrap this thing. Now we want this to be as efficient as possible so that we don't get too many seams visible. Now, especially if you're planning to take this to maybe something like Photoshop, you really want to make sure that the seams are not too visible. And the seams are normally going to be more visible where you cut. So that's what we're going to do right now. So the first thing I'm going to do is only select the inside of the mouth. So just try to follow along as I select some of the edges here. Hopefully you can see this clearly. So I'm looking at which edges I'm going to select. Probably this one. See, maybe that's not what I want. I know it's really difficult to see, but try to follow us as close as possible. Also remember that this video is available to you in high definition. Let me disable reflection for now. We don't need that anymore. I'm probably going to select those edges. Okay, so I think that would be fine for now, because I want the mouth to be separate from the rest so that it can be easily UV unwrapped. So now let's go to the legs here. So probably want to click here. Okay, maybe not that one. Maybe that edge loop there. That looks fine. Now let's go to the back one and select this loop. Make sure you're selecting all the way around. If you don't select it all the way around, you may have problems later when you unwrap this. So let's select this loop, probably this one, that, and that. Now let's do the same with this one. Goes all around, all the way around. So that looks fine for now. I'm going to select this edge, double click to here, Make sure it goes all the way to the loop that we have there at the top. Make sure they meet. And we're going to do the same with the other leg here, all the way up. Now the reason we're doing it in the inside as opposed to the other side is, of course, because I want to minimize the seam visibility, especially if you do this in Photoshop. So we can double check that we have everything the way we want it before we go ahead and unwrap. So I think this is looking fine for now. So all these should work fine. We may have some problems with the mouth, but we're gonna have to check first, see what happens. So let's go to the window UV texture editor. So that brings this up. We can see our dinosaur mesh with polygons, cut UV edges, go back to polygons, and unfold. Now go back to polygons just to lay out. I'm going to click here to select the whole object. Let me rotate that just so I can see that. I think it looks fine for now, and we can come back to it later, see what's going on there. Now, in the case of this one, probably have to fix it. So this one's the mouth. Let's try to unfold just to see if we get a better result here. See what we get. Now, it's not looking the way I want it really, so maybe if we select a point here, you know, it might be difficult to see if I select it. What if I select this loop? And if I go to the polygons and I go to the options box for unfold and I select here, see what that does. And I think looks better. It's not too bad. Of course, probably this is not the optimal way for this to be, but I think it works. Let's continue to try to unfold it, see if we get a better result. Now you can see we have some overlapping here, so I'm going to use the unfold there. I think it works, it shouldn't be a problem. I mean, we can see that the tongue is here. I'm going to assign a material to this, what is called a UV grid. So if we go here to look for our material, Lambert 1, we'll assign that material. I'm going to be assigning a grid material. It's a grid texture. It's a, you can Google for a distortion texture for UVs. And you can also get this one from my website. So we have a grid, and the less distortion we have, the better. So as we can see here, I don't see too much distortion. So all the little squares look fine, they don't look too distorted. You see how that looks here? It doesn't look too bad, it looks fine. So now let me select this one, which is that leg. So I want this to be a little straight, So I'm going to select a UV point and maybe this one. Go back to the unfold. Make sure it's set to pin selected UVs. And that looks better now. I do the same with this one. Go to select the UV point, with that one, and go to polygons, unfold. Now click here to select the whole object. Click here to unfold. Now this one doesn't look so bad, although it could be slightly better. Now this one's horrible. We want it to be better than this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select and convert selection to faces. I'm going to create UVs. I'm going to click on the options box here and set it to best plane. Make sure it's set to best plane. What it does, it creates a better looking UV based on the normals of that area. So if we unfold it slightly more. So that looks way better than what it was before. So I'm actually going to do the same with this one, see if we get a difference, different results. So convert to faces, that planar mapping that's already set to the best plane actually came out really similar, but just in case. Now we're going to select these are obviously not what we want, so we're going to go ahead and do the, if you try to unfold, nothing really happening, so let's go to select and convert that to faces and do the same thing. Now, up first, we see that we have some overlapping there, but if we unfold in a minute here, if we unfold it, you see that the overlapping is now gone. And that looks way, way better than what it initially was. Let's do the same with this one. Convert to faces, planar mapping. Select the whole object. I'm going to scale that down just so that I can see it better. I'm going to unfold it. Okay. So that looks fine for now. Now let me select this, the whole thing here. See how that, what's going on with this one. Let's try to unfold. It actually looks fine to me. I don't see problems here. I just want to make sure we don't have any overlapping. Maybe here, if I do actually unfold in this case, doesn't do a good job. So probably if I do relax really slightly, not much. I'm actually going to relax this one as well. And actually this one looks fine. I don't see problems with it. So it looks fine for now. So let's select everything and go back to layout. And now it didn't do a very good job to pack this into our UV space here, but I'm going to leave it like that for now and come back to that in a few seconds here. So now let's unfold the eye. Now that's super easy. If we go to create, let's go back to bounding box here. Now let's go back to the window UV texture editor. Let's unfold it. unfold it so that we have a cleaner looking eye here. Now that's actually looking fine. So now we're going to combine everything together actually. Let me select the eye here and whoops. Scale that down. So I'm going to combine these two. You select both objects and go to mesh combine. So now they're one object. And they're going to be using the same UV texture space. Not space, but the same grid space. So I'm going to combine them to the teeth as well. Make sure you select from the outside and so that you have selected all of them. So now let's combine these, select all of them and go back to mesh combine. Then go ahead and delete our history. Now we make sure that we're using our pixel space better than this so that we can pack everything better in the we want to make sure that we use the most space available in this so that we don't waste any pixels. So all I'm going to do is scale some of the things and make sure I'm using all the space available here. So I'm going to leave it this way for now. So we want to get to the making a mirror of this one. Mirror geometry, that's what I meant. So you might get a seam here where we cut the UVs. Just make sure that you're aware of that. So at this point we want to mirror geometry so that we have one object. So I'm going to delete the image first. So I think in Maya 2013 you can just select it and delete. Let me undo that and if you go to Window, Rendering Editor, Hypershade. Now this is if you want to delete that background image that you have. So I think you can find it in the under the cameras. You can select it and you can just delete. So now we don't have that image there anymore. So now we're done with the UV unwrapping and we want the mirror geometry here. So go to mesh and go to mirror geometry options box. Make sure you set to the X unless you were working with something else. Make sure you set this way. Now it's a good thing to just come in and check that everything looks fine. You don't have any geometry that you were not expecting. That's what I'm going to do right now. Let me just double check. Everything is fine. So it looks fine. So if we go to the UVs, now it looks everything's fine. Now we have more, we have overlapping because, as I said, this is going to be a symmetrical object. Dinosaur is going to be symmetrical, so that's why we have overlapping. So at this point, we have our model, and if that's all you wanted to learn, if you wanted to learn how to model, that this is it. This is where I'm stopping in the modeling process. So we're basically done with our dinosaur. So to make sure that you don't have any end guns, that's the last thing I'm going to talk about here. If you go to mesh, clean up. Here, if you set this way so that Maya doesn't fix the end guns for you, and it only shows them to you so that you can fix them. Now, what end guns are more than four-sided polygons, more than four-sided faces. So if we hit apply and it deselects the object, that means that we're clear, we don't have any end guns. So if you had any end guns, it would highlight those faces so that you can fix them. Now actually let me demonstrate here. If I delete this edge and I select the object, and if I hit apply, see how it selected that face so that I know that I have an end gun there. So let me undo that. So this is it. Now if you want to texture this, you can use Photoshop or ZBrush or Mudbox. I recommend you use ZBrush or Mudbox. It's probably the easiest way to go. So we're basically done with the modeling process. So I would like to see your models, if you were able to make it this far. I would like to see some pictures of the model that you were able to complete based on this tutorial series.